We are so delighted to have you here as we honor Black History, mind, body, and soul.
I'm Ron Corning, along with Jenny Ann Chondo and Yolanda Williams as well, joining us with an extraordinary story of a woman who is a storyteller extraordinaire. Yolanda?
Yes, Diane Tucker, producer and storyteller extraordinaire. This East Texas native has made a huge impact in the lives of performers right here in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. Take a look.
Playwright, storyteller, lyricist. The fascinating life of Diane Tucker. Diane Tucker was born April 3rd, 1951. The third child born to Azri and Aline Tucker. Well, I'll let her tell it.
My siblings were all born in a hospital. I was not. I was born in my grandmother's house. And my mother had been at a hospital for a couple of days, and I simply refused to come. I think I had other plans. So they brought her back home after 3 days, and she went to my grandmother's house for a visit, and suddenly I decided I would like to be born here, and I would like to be born now.
Diane loved entertaining from the jump. Who else would spend their Saturday mornings recruiting non-union neighborhood kids to perform her original songs and dances? In the early 60s, the Tucker clan packed up and left the piney woods of East Texas and headed west to Fort Worth. In 1966, Azri and Aline opened Tucker's Diner, right smack dab in the middle of the Riverside neighborhood in Fort Worth, where artists like the Texas Tornado himself, U.P. Woolson, performed on stage. You walk around all the time. Diane went on to earn her bachelor's and master's degrees from UNT and SMU. Diane also worked in HR at various corporations in Dallas. But on December 16, 1976, at a Rockwell International Company Christmas party, Diane decided to dance with Roland Young. Well, that must have been quite a dance because they got married in March of 1980. Diane's love of the arts never went away. In the 1990s, Diane and husband Roland Young, along with Diane's brother Larry Tucker, they formed the Dallas Drama Company, a small nonprofit performing company where Diane's original work was produced, such as Cat Cross, Shoes, and When Effie Burke Passed. The Tucker siblings always talked about opening a blues club just like their parents did in Fort Worth back in the 60s. Fast forward 40 years later, Diane, her husband Roland, along with brother Larry and his wife Wanda, brought the blues back home to Deep Ellum. Tucker's Blues opened on Commerce Street in 2009. Celebrating local blues acts, the timing was just right. After facing unending challenges, Tucker's closed its doors in 2013. In April of last year, friends, family, and performers from Dallas Drama Company and Tucker's Blues got together to celebrate Diane's 70th birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Sadly, we lost Diane New Year's Day after her battle with cancer. A celebration of life service was held in her honor to show how much she was appreciated and loved. When I was getting all of this together, I realized I had a voicemail on my phone that I had not played in quite some time.
Hey, Yolanda, it's me. Sorry I missed you. I saw you on my caller ID when we were still in Mexico. We came back Sunday. Had a great trip. Hope you're doing good. I just wanted to touch bases with you, let you know I was thinking about you so I could say, hey, Yolanda. I'll let you later.
So sweet that you had that you're sharing it with us.
I know. Diane was a creative force, and she was so loved by so many people in the arts community. It was a big loss for us.
And gone too soon.
Gone too soon.
Just at
absolutely.
70. My
yes.
goodness. Yeah, what a legacy she
we
leaves.
We love Diane.
That voicemail, Yolanda. I was ill prepared for that at the end there. I didn't know you had that saved.
And I'm so glad. I'm so notorious for not deleting my voicemails. I'm so glad that it, you know, it worked in my favor this time that I still have that.
Yeah,
and
let
I can listen to it.
Yeah. Let that be a note to all of us with those that we love and care about. Like, file some of them away, even if you email them to yourself.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, I totally do. Yes, I totally do that. Yeah. I save one from every family member, just, you know, and people I care about, just in case they're there.
Thank you, Yolanda. I appreciate that. And we'll be back here with more in just a moment. Stay with us.